Welcome to SharpCloud Onboarding. In this first lesson, you will learn how to see your data in different ways within your SharpCloud story. Let's get started. Your general workspace in SharpCloud is called a story. Each story is made up of two main components, data and views. To get more specific, data is made up of items, relationships, and attributes in SharpCloud. If we put this into familiar terms like a spreadsheet, think of an item like the rows, and the columns which provide context to the item are attributes. Views are SharpCloud's data-driven way of visualizing your story's information and can change depending on your needs and the questions needing answers. For example, let's say that I'm a project manager and I'm analyzing my team's project load. I can see this view of all of the projects and their priority status, but I can also switch to a second view to see a timeline of everyone's projects that enables me to visualize start and end dates and project durations broken down by their owner. Going back to the first view, I can visualize my data and make it easier to see patterns, clusters, and gaps, which is impossible to see in classic spreadsheets. Straight away, I see that Steven has loads of high-priority projects, and Andy has all low-priority. Then, I can change the context of the view by right-clicking and switching the access property to another attribute. Doing this provides a different perspective of the same data, revealing more insights. Now I know that Steven has loads of high-priority projects that are all behind schedule. Maybe Andy can step in and help Steven get back on track. Adding a new view is as easy as clicking the Add button in the view strip on the left side of the screen, then selecting the type of view I'd like to create and configuring the attributes to my liking. Now I have a new view to help answer more important questions, but that's just the start. Now that I have a general idea of how my SharpCloud story is built, I can drill down into the details by applying interactive filters at the bottom of my screen. In this SharpCloud view, I'm seeing the big picture of the full dataset, but I can narrow my focus and eliminate noise to only see Rachel's projects that are on track by filtering. Wow, it looks like she has a few. Great job, Rachel. I can reset interactive filters at any time to reset our view back to its default settings. As a project manager, these are a few quick views that provide insights into how my team is working and how projects are progressing, enabling me to create actionable steps to ensure my team's efficiency. If you're feeling stuck, a great place to start is asking yourself 3 to 5 questions that you might not be able to answer today, and building SharpCloud views to help find answers. Hopefully, this quick lesson has helped you understand how to see your data in different ways by adding new views and applying filters to drill down into the important parts or points within your story. Join us in Lesson 2, where we'll be discussing story customization, filtering, and creating panels to make more informed decisions.